A very good morning, sir. I welcome you to my podcast. I'm really thankful that you gave me time for this podcast.
Yeah, you're welcome, Chandar. It's a great pleasure to interact with you through this podcast, and I will try my best to, you know, share my experiences through your bombardment of the questions.
I was actually surprised to see your profile. I was actually amazed, and that's why I thought that I should contact you for a podcast. And so I was like, okay, how can a person do so much in his life? You know, that's the thing that came in my life, and you have in my mind, and you have a really good interaction with your students. I also saw your videos, the one which you took as an FDP, where you were telling others about how to write a research paper. So that's what actually told me that, no, I should talk with you about all of this and I should interact with you. So there are some things that I want to ask you. That when I saw your profile, I saw that you had been teaching in Thapar since 9 years now. So how has your experience been in Thapar?
You know, it is a great question. As far as, you know, my engagements at Thapar Institute is concerned, it is we say learning as well as the experiencing learning. Mm-hmm. So I'm enjoying the teaching, research. I have very good engagement with my professor colleagues, right? So overall, if you see, it is almost 9 years, so I'm completing, 10 years soon. So it is a great experience, and there was a lot of learning as far as, my classes scheduling and everything is concerned. Mm-hmm. So though it was a very hectic for me, besides other teaching loads, like these FDPs you were talking about, right? Mm-hmm. So in that sense, it was quite cumbersome for me. Mm-hmm. But yes, because of my own pursuit and the way, I'm working and I take the interest. So everything managed well. So in a cut short, I can, explicitly conclude this question that it was a great experience, and I got a very good platform here for my teaching, learning and research, and a lot of motivations from my students as well, because they always come to and see me in my, office, and they ask me, sir, what new you are doing? So that is also sounds great that students, they are inspiring me, and I'm sharing. Even just before this call also, there was another project I'm working with my students. Okay. So it's an engagement is all about, Chandan.
That's great. So and what is that?
I believe in knowledge sharing, so I'm just sharing with my knowledge and everything.
So what is that one thing will you like to tell to someone who has just joined the Thapar as a teacher? So what would you like to tell him or her?
To a teacher?
Yeah.
To a teacher, I must say that you take deep interest, whatever the positions you have been hired and the course allocated to the gentlemen or to the ladies or professors. So my as experience that they should not, superficially connect with the students. So that is one of my message I would like to share across this medium, that they should take interest, and once they are in the system, they should engage, and they should be honest enough in their portfolio so that they can teach well, research well, and engage well, and motivate the students.
That's good. So as a part of your education, I saw that you have done BSc and BTech. Now, how did that come from? I was actually even surprised to see this.
Yeah, actually, if you see my scholarly engagement since my graduation, I was, very much, excited. And I made my plan actually when I was in class 12 and all. So I thought that there was an interest coming to the science actually. So once I got the science, then I was experiencing that, something is left, right? Okay. Something is left that, I should impart my something education in engineering. So, Chandan, you appreciate that, or the viewers will also appreciate that. I opted some half courses in my university from the engineering department.
Okay.
Just to satisfy my queries.
Okay.
You know how the things are working, because in science there was a complete scenario of education based on experiments, principles, and all. We all know that. So that was not new and exciting for me actually.
Okay.
So that inspires me a lot, and so I requested my professors in my university where I graduated, and they have given me the one option, because that was the option available with the university. But you know, rarest of the rarest case, the students go and opt some courses in the other departments.
Okay.
It is one of the rarest, I think. Hope you also believe that.
Yes.
So because many times, you know, what happens, students are not completing their own courses which are allocated in their own faculty, in their own department. So that thing motivates me. So then I requested my professor there, sir, I am interested to have something knowledge based, something non-credit or something credit, you know. So he suggested, there were 2-3 professors still who motivated me. No, here one option is there. You can opt for all 3 engineering courses. Chandan, all 3 courses. So namely the 3 courses were automobile engineering, mechanical engineering, and electrical engineering.
Okay.
So that particular course, formally I have enrolled in that with the permission of the university and the consent taken from my current department, which was, I belongs to the faculty of science, because I was doing a simple BSc course there, having a specialization in the area of physics and electronics. Okay. So I was lucky enough to have that particular course, but there was another precondition there.
Okay.
Because no institute or department run a course less than 3, 2, or 5 students.
Yep. Yes, this happens.
And I was the only one. So okay. I was not meeting the university requirement. So my professor again asked me and motivated me that you can also consult to your colleagues, your friends. If they may be interested like you, we can run this course.
Okay.
So finally I enough to have 2 of my batchmates who shown the interest, okay, let's take this course, half course. We call it as a half course, means some courses have been joined in the other department.
Okay.
So I successfully joined, completed. Then interest came, then full interest came. Then I decided to go and pursue the full time in engineering.
Okay. That's great. So
that
That's
was the point actually, that was the turning point in my life, where I was directly connected with the engineering principles, experiments, everything. Means I enjoyed the engineering course much more than the sciences.
Okay. Now I get it. That's great. That's actually a great thing. Okay. Even I didn't knew about this, that these things also can happen when we are doing our bachelor's. So talking about your master's, it's in alternate hydro energy systems. What does that mean actually? I'm actually still confused about that. What does it mean?
I will help you to understand. It is one of the unique course available in India, only in IIT Roorkee, right? So, and this course is related to more in electrical engineering, because having said that, my specialization was electrical engineering. I have done BTech in electrical engineering from the same institute. So linking to this one, I have qualified the GATE examination during my 3rd year of my program, okay? In engineering. So I was, as I told you before, that I was much interested to pursue, and interest came, you know, when you are a student and some interest came. I was sitting with my professors, they also motivated me, Rudra, you do this, and if you want to do this you have to qualify. So I got lot of guidance from Professor VG Das. He was a person, he was a mentor during my sciences and throughout my life, or maximum of my life, because of him I'm here.
Okay.
So he understood my interest, and he guided me well, and he motivated me to go and qualify this GATE examination when I was in the 3rd year of the program.
Okay.
And luckily I qualified that GATE qualification examination in the 3rd year itself, and applied for IITs for master's program. Okay. and I was I had a two plan. Suppose by chance I'm not getting through into the IITs, then I thought that okay, I should continue my M.Tech program in the same institute because the program was available.
Okay.
But I was very much clear about my educational plans that I should not compromise and I should not waste my time a year in this institute or that institute.
Obviously.
I believe that wherever I work, I am common, my education is common, more or less course syllabi, course syllabus. Ultimately, we are the students who can do anything if they wish to do so.
Yes.
So I had a 2-3 backup plans. Okay, if get qualified, then I can apply. I could take, some clear cut decision. I consult my parents also. So I'm the only son to my parents.
That would also be a big issue at home.
So my mother was also not interested to send me outside. Okay. So that was also a very difficult task. But anyhow, I requested my mother and make her understand about my aspirations and qualifications, right? So luckily I applied in all the IITs. So I got calls from IIT Bombay, IIT Madras, IIT Delhi, IIT Roorkee and all. But interest is different thing where you are searching. So I got for M.Tech program. But Roorkee having a special feeling for me. Because my father also studied from the institute, University of Roorkee.
Okay.
So when he was studying, so that thing motivates me further to select and I should go with the IIT Roorkee.
Okay. That's great.
So this program was the unique one. Having said that, because I was more interested to become the specialized person in the area of energy systems.
Okay.
Okay. With a flavor of hydro. So this course is the only course available in India. No other IITs is offering. So that's why I enrolled and applied in this. Though I was getting admission in pure power system, power electronics. But I thought that, okay, I can do something in hydropower.
Yes, yes.
So that's why, and luckily I qualified that entrance because they also conduct some interview or something, when they recruit the students for the master's program. That is the policy of IIT. So finally, I got that admission and decided to continue the 2 years program in that specialization.
That's great. That's actually great. Yeah. So did you face that same thing in IIT that you faced during your bachelor's, that if there would be less students, then that course cannot run? So was the same thing there in IIT also?
No, IIT we do not have, only because they prepare the merit list actually.
Okay.
So I still remember that there were total 14 students were required to run the program.
Okay.
And there was a lot of applications, so they need to scrutinize many students, because it is a national institute of importance and one of the oldest institute, and Roorkee is a special case because University of Roorkee was also the very famous university in Asia.
Yes.
Asia's oldest engineering institution, right? And after that, it was converted into IIT.
Yes.
So that also thing also motivates me. And one thing I forgot to mention here during my previous comments, that because parallelly from the engineering to the M.Tech program, I was attending many national seminars, walking into national seminars, presented my ideas, papers and all. So I was more inspired by the other audiences also. Like I was meeting with some professors from IIT Delhi, some IIT Roorkee, some IIT Kanpur. You understand? And during my B.Tech program, I got a chance to do some summer internship at IIT Kanpur.
Okay.
So during my second year, if I'm not wrong, so in second year, when I was in second year of my B.Tech program, I got an selection from IIT Kanpur. So who attracts me that, and when I went to IIT Kanpur, then I changed my mind and I decided to go in this higher education system.
Okay.
So that thing, I think I missed out somewhere during my comments related to the question. So then you see, parallelly, I was getting the knowledge from the people. I was getting the knowledge from audience. So I was more connected. I was more connected with the conference. Scientists. I attended two, three conferences from DRDO, some conferences. So that thing, motivates me a lot. Though I was not very much knowledgeable at that point in time, but one thing I have captured that, okay, these guys are doing wonderful job. And if I can do hard work, because it was not a very easiest journey for me, right? It was a full of struggle, full of preparation, full of this examination, that examination, right? So, but one thing was clear to me that I can also do and contribute significantly in the research area, in the academics.
Got your point.
So, coming back to your question, then this particular specializations helps me to understand better me, to establish me better. And one thing, institution also matters, qualification course also matters in the life of a person.
They actually do matter. Actually do
Yes,
matter. Yes.
yes.
So talking about your PhD. Your PhD topic was strategic energy technology management. So again,
Yes.
you pursued that same field in order to how to manage the
Yes.
energy. So that's great. You took a special line, then continued it in your master's and further continued in your PhD, right? So this is,
Yeah.
I guess, this is one of the best things to do, because I have seen some cases that they have done some other work in their MTech and some other work in PhD. So what they say that this makes their field diverse. But in your case, it has been a kind of same work that
Oh,
has
it
been
is no,
continued.
Chandan. Here I would like to correct one thing and add one
Yeah,
thing.
please.
This is not the same course actually.
Okay.
There are two different courses because that was a purely an engineering project.
Okay.
Okay,
Yes.
so that project MTech thesis I have done on the power
Alternate
system.
hydrogen. Huh. Alternate
No,
hydrogen
power
system.
system.
Okay.
Alternate hydro energy system was the specialization of the entire program. Entire program is the degree name, you call it, degree name. Now I don't know whether they have changed it or not, because they at that point in time they were discussing.
Okay.
And these particular specializations was conceptualized with the help of Ministry of Power
Okay.
at that point in time. Okay. And this particular department is one of the consulting department of IIT Roorkee. So this particular department also helps me to understand about the consultancy initiatives, how they are working, powers, projects and all. They have in program, this particular center from where I have done the master's program. So they are also providing trainings to the professionals.
Okay.
Okay. But in that particular program, we all students need to choose, one
What?
specialization
Yes,
linking
yes.
to our background. Okay.
Yes, yes.
So my background was electrical engineering.
Yes.
So I have the only one choice to work with the projects like biomass gas energification or something. So there I have done one common thing that I have opted the program in power system. Power system is pure electrical engineering.
Yes, it
So
is.
that was the, so one of my professor Singh was there. He was my mentor guide, and only two, three students he was guiding, because there was a, I told you there was only 14 to 15 students were there in entire batch. So two, three students attached to two, three professor, two, three students attached to the two, three professor. And this particular department having a beauty, because there are a blend of professors and the scientists.
Yes.
It is not a pure department. Having said that, it is comprising of all the professors. As I told you, it is a consulting department.
Yes.
It generates a lot of funds to the IIT Roorkee. Bringing the energy projects from Ministry of Power or other, PCRA or some other, other ministries too.
That's true.
So this thing, but in PhD, as you were talking about, I was interested to formulate some research title, because when I admitted in the management, During this transition of MTech and PhD program, as I told you, I've got a lot of awards also, mm-hmm. right, during my conferences mm-hmm. at academia.
Yes.
So in 2002, if I'm not wrong, when I was in engineering, then I met with Professor Kalam, Dr. Abdul Kalam.
Okay.
In Bangalore. Mm-hmm. So I was in the category of awardee. I got the Indian Science Congress Best Poster Presentation Award.
Mm-hmm.
And I was the youngest one to receive that award.
Okay.
Otherwise, that particular award mostly professors or researchers, they do.
Mm-hmm.
But I was not a researcher at that point in time, but I have floated one of my idea, submitted to the conference, and finally got selected. I got an invite, I've attended. I got the award also. I selected also.
Okay.
So Dr. Abdul Kalam motivated all the young scientists there, where all the awardees, and he mentioned something during his plenary session expert talk, that mm-hmm. if you guys can do something in management, mm-hmm. you remember,
mm-hmm.
something you can do in management, I think you can do the fantastic job.
Okay.
So that was the transition point, and that was somewhere in my mind to let's do first. Mm-hmm. I was clear to formally complete my formal education.
Yes.
That is up to MTech program, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then, you know, some interest came, and I opted during my MTech program, after the MTech program, done, you know, business diploma and business entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
1 year diploma, okay? So that thing and Dr. Kalam's advice, that is the outcome of the PhD of management.
Okay.
You understand?
Yes. So the motivation came from there, actually.
From there, and some interest came. Okay,
yes,
you know,
yes.
I know all these things, I'm doing it,
mm-hmm.
and I can do much better. But mm-hmm. there was another challenge, that I can't continue with the same project because management line is different.
Mm-hmm.
And I got the various calls from IIT Madras, I still remember, for the PhD. People were interested. And the powerful thing was with me, because I was, writer, actually. I was doing research, publishing my paper in webinars, seminars and all. So mm-hmm. many professors, they were very enthusiastic to guide me, actually, as a research scholar.
Okay.
Many professors, they requested me, I do not have the fellowship. So in a nutshell, I'm giving you, then you can quantify, okay, which question belongs to this. So it was a journey, actually.
Okay.
So some professors having the fellowship, some professors having not a fellowship, mm-hmm. not a vacancy. You know, PhD always works with the vacancy.
Mm-hmm.
It is not like that, okay, all professors have the vacancy to recruit mm-hmm. or hire.
Mm-hmm. Understand.
So that thing, this title, you know, came, this area came to my mind, that, okay, I can do something in energy, because that was the area with my MTech related issue. Okay. Then technology management is the area falling into the management. So I've decided to go for the strategic technology or something. And these were the my coursework subjects also.
Okay.
So I have opted technology management in my coursework.
Mm-hmm.
I've opted, you know, service marketing in my coursework, marketing management,
mm-hmm.
and some related to this, so that I can attach with this and nobody can question me, okay, I am from the different domain
mm-hmm.
and I'm doing some different domain problem.
So in order to balance out that, you opted the courseworks according to this, so that mm-hmm. they ultimately point out towards your actual work that you want to do.
Let's get
justifies all of those things. That's actually a very good point, that I guess anyone who hears this will be able to get that. If your topic is a kind of way out of the work that you have done, you can plan out your coursework according to that, so it justifies your topic.
Yes.
Okay, that's great. That's
and Chandan, I would like to add one thing before moving to the next question. You know, there has to be a connection, actually. So the message to the audience, to the budding scholars, is that they should not go something is, you know, orange is orange, apple is apple.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, yes.
But both are fruits. Both are fruits. But there has to be connection in the, in the studies, so that you can better, you know, formulate your own plan. And if you see my plan, this from BSc Engineering, then Technology, MTech. So if you see from science, engineering, technology, management, social sciences, these days I'm working in the area of social sciences, English literature, right? So you can see it is a complete transformation. And the one thing is this, the common thing is the interest and your connection of the education.
Yes. I got your point. So after your PhD, you also got this National Doctoral Fellowship Award from AICTE. So what is it? Means how can a person go for this? How can a person apply for this NDF, yes, National Doctoral Follow?
So Chandan, it is a great question that you have pointed out. Everything, happened when I was, because I generally spend time with me actually.
Okay.
So having said that, I told you, I got the fellowship, I qualified, get examination and all, right? So IIT, because I was continuing the same education system, so PhD was the second program for me in the same institution, right? So I was much aware about the regulations. I know professors, I know their expectation, right? So everything was very good actually. I was getting timely fellowship, everything, because that was the gate fellowship. You understand? Yes. So I got the fellowship during my MTech program also.
And PhD.
And the same thing continued with this. So there was a leverage that those people who are pursuing the PhD further, they will also qualify, because there are allocations actually in institute. Mm-hmm. Every student will not get the fellowship actually.
Mm-hmm.
So again, they will make the rubric and roster and all these things that you need. So luckily I got the fellowship, MHRD fellowship. I continued with the with the same institute, but departments were different.
Mm-hmm.
But the institute was same, candidature was same, everything was same. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I was much aware about, I was much clear about this particular thing. But one thing interesting, idea came. I was thinking actually when I was doing my, PhD assignment and coursework, right? So then some idea came that to me suddenly, actually, it wasn't sudden actually.
Mm-hmm.
So Google was in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
So I was asking from myself, okay, I'm not doing anything extraordinary or anything differently actually.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this IIT is full of scholars, some idea was coming. Same thing I'm sharing with you, I still remember. Okay, so I asked some question, okay, many students are there, they are doing the same job. So I'm not doing something differently actually.
Mm-hmm.
So there has to be some other title also, like national doctoral or something like this. So that thing inspires me actually.
Okay.
Okay, because national doctoral is another title.
Yes, so, yes, it is.
So, okay, you understand, research scholar is a research scholar, SRF, senior research fellow is senior research fellow.
Mm.
So idea came, I was sitting just like, in front of my laptop and all, when I was doing my coursework, everything. Suddenly idea came, I'm not doing anything extra actually.
Mm-hmm.
So, without wasting much time, fraction of second, I Google it. I search it. Okay, there must be some, fellowship or something, at least I can try.
Mm-hmm.
So, then I was searching the Google, and Google filter out the information.
Mm-hmm.
And luckily I got this AICT fellowship. And the luckiest point was this one, still the deadline was on,
Okay, so you still had time. You still had time. So one of the things that you...
So I applied the application and I have been invited for the interview. That is the biggest interview I have faced in ever in my life.
Okay.
So, there was a very, very tough panel, they made in the ministry, AICT and all. So they make the special arrangements and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So even I was not very much ambitious to get it, because I was getting... If you understand, but still I try to, okay, let's understand, at least I will learn something. Okay,
yes.
That was the only inspiration for me, and I went there, I attended the successful interview and everything. Their professors, they were very much impressed with looking my profile, because I was writing papers, I was getting fellowship, I was getting IIT tag and everything. Even some of the interview panelists were also telling the same thing, Rudri, you have this. So what was the point to apply for such a highest fellowship?
Mm-hmm.
So then I said that, sir, it is always good to the scholar moves, go to the higher level of the research.
So
that was the only answer I gave to my professor, though I was satisfied. I was not like that. I was totally blank. And I was actually making the plan from the current program for the next program. So that thing helps me a lot to structurize the entire thing.
Mm-hmm.
even now also as a professor, I am thinking, okay, what I have to do in next 5 years like this. So I'm not in hurry. I was not in hurry. Mm-hmm. And that thing suited to me. And finally, letter came through the IIT Roorkee director, because AICT always communicate not to the head or anything. They always communicate with the director of the institute.
Okay.
So they mark one copy to that, and they mark one copy to the candidate through the
mm-hmm.
So finally I got the highest fellowship, and that and when I went there to the AICT, there I came to know that there is only among all IITs and IIMs in management area.
Only what? Okay.
One vacancy was there. Yeah.
Okay. And that you got. Wow.
Yeah. So that when I went there, then there was another, you know, tough competition. People came from the industry, people having a more experience than me, you know, everything was there. So because these fellowships never announce in open platform, like a newspaper or daily news. Okay. This vacancy in this vacancy in that. Right? So from there only I came to know that there is a tough competition in management. And we were total, still, I remember there were total 9 to 10 candidates actually.
Oh, okay.
So and many candidates were very strong than me. They were from different IITs. Mm-hmm. They have industrial experience also. Because you know that many people come to IIT for research having some industrial experience.
Yes.
But I do not have. So at calculation, I was at the, weak foot, you can say, weak foot.
Yes,
from the industry point of view, because they have the additive advantage, right? So then I changed my strategy there, and I formulated, because you know it is the biggest interview, and no second chance will be come. So before entering to the interview, I think I was the fourth one called for the interview.
Okay,
in the list. Okay, so out of 9 or 10, because they were signing, so there that list, you know, I came to know that okay, in management these are the people. And there was even ma'am was there. So she helped me. It is a very tough competition, because in sciences 2 vacancy, in physical sciences 2 vacancy, in this. So, you know, they have the roster, all the discipline. Management was one. So management, the AICT was offering to one at that point. So, but yes, I made my mind, and I never, you know, make anything just for the sake of, you know, giving the answers, right? So it was not like that. Everything was from my heart, even now also, while you are asking this. So I attended successfully all the interviews and gave the answers and all, and professor appreciated while looking at my profile. Okay, you have published so many papers, you know. At that point in time, I published 35 papers.
Oh, that's great, that's great.
30 to 35 papers I published at that point in time, because papers actually drives me a lot actually.
Okay.
Papers drives me a lot, because I was started paper writing from my BSc, you know, program.
Yes.
So that.
So one of the things that you just pointed out is a concept of self-talk. As you said that you, most of the time you talk with yourself, okay, what I need to do, what anything needs to be done, and everything. And I see this element is missing nowadays, because the time that we have for self-talk is taken by the phones. We just pick up our phone and do start something. So we don't get a time for the self-talk. So I wanted to know from you that for a person who is doing a kind of research, what is the importance of a self-talk for such person?
So it is a good question. Actually, because of competitive environment these days in corporates, academia, people have no time. Even in families also, people have no time, right?
Yes.
So, but this is an opposed kind of situation of our life. So I believe, even I'm experiencing now also, even today also in Sunday, I'm still sitting in the office, right? So in this, you know, hectic life, one should spare some time and organize their working task. Okay. And as I told you, even now I'm committing, I have planned the things what I will do in another 5 years.
Yes.
And I am not in competition. Right, I am not in competition. Wherever you go, people ask them, sir, you have achieved so much thing in short age of time and everything. So it's okay. I'm getting everyday award, blessings, all these things, right? Through email or something. So that is a booster kind of thing. That is the one of the result I'm getting on the way actually. Okay. That is there. Because if people not appreciate me, it does not mean that I will stop working.
Obviously.
Right. Some people want name, fame, everything. I believe that what we should be genuine enough and we should contribute. I'm not saying that on this channel that I have done anything great. No, I have not done anything great. I'm claiming that it was a journey. Whatever things I have understood while, you know, experiencing all these things, then I decided, okay. So one should give time to ourselves and think, organize the things and motivate ourselves, help others. So having a blend of these is a very difficult thing in today's time. But it is not the impossible. People can easily. Yes,
they can.
People can easily, you know, structureize themselves very easily. Because now technology is helping the people. Now technology is bringing the people together. It is a case of time management, empathy, communication, your behavior, your trust, your rituals, right?
Yes.
Your etiquettes, everything.
That's great.
Because everything helps actually.
Yes, it does. Even for me, the day I realize this thing that I need to spend time with myself, because we need to have ideas, we need to plan. And for that, spending time with ourselves is actually very, very important. Otherwise, these things cannot be done.
Yes.
If you're not. So coming back to the things that we were talking about, you have been a visiting faculty also at many institutes. So what I wanted to specifically ask that what is the main role of a visiting faculty?
I think it is a common practice followed by the institutes and the universities. And this thing works based on the recommendations and the availability. Okay. Because it is a both ways. Many people, they believe that, okay, something happened for somebody, you know, it is not. Actually, the recommendation goes from the institute, some scholar, some faculty, and sometimes it is availability, as I told you before. So is there availability? So visiting faculty is a very common practice followed by the institutions and universities, even not in India, even in abroad also. Okay. So whenever invitation comes to me and they formulate, they ask me, sir, would you be interested in this? Okay, this is the course. Because they match their requirement with my requirement and my availability of the
time. Yes.
So if the things matches, we have to take the leave from this, or I will finish the course with this. So that is a usual practice. So nothing great in this.
So let us suppose I am a visiting faculty. You have called me as a visiting faculty. So what do you expect from me being a visiting faculty at your institute?
It is a good question. So I always expect that the person should be specialized and take interest to guide the students.
Okay.
And complete the syllabus also. So I'm adding one point, because at time what happened that I'm not naming the institute or naming the faculties. Many faculties, they are in hurry-burry as far as the, visiting faculty status is concerned.
Okay.
Because they run the show and they complete the syllabus in hurry-burry, right? Which is not a correct practice. So I'm against this practice because faculty is a faculty, because you are not permanently hired by some XYZ university, right?
Obviously.
You know, they are also running the program, but because of some scarcity, suppose professor is not available or unwell. So under those circumstances, a course should not suffer. Then the university goes for the recommendation and asks the visiting faculty to come. And sometimes it is also with the knowledge also.
Yes.
In management's area, there is a kind of, you can say, competition. because they want to give the flavor, external flavor, because every professor have their own style, content, delivery, pedagogy, case studies, examples. You understand? So these things varies from faculty to faculty. But now the trend is like that. We all are living in modern and digital world where we are talking about Industry 4.0 and Industry 5.0 coming by the next decade, right? So where technology is also improving, profession is also improving, student expectations are also improving. So to meet up their demand, universities and institutes generally, or you can say majorly, they look at the visiting faculty assignments.
Okay.
So if I would like to invite you, then I will expect that you satisfy my students, you complete the syllabus with interest, right? And because there is a connection. If your first connection is fruitful, then definitely you have the higher chances to be called by, not me, by someone.
Yes, yes. Obviously,
it depends upon the quality. So again, everything is related to the quality lectures.
Okay, that's great. That's great. Yeah. So, as a part of your stay at Thapar, you were involved in the placement and internship at Thapar. So, you were part of that. So, how should I decide which internship should I go for? Let's suppose I am a student who is looking for an internship. So how will I finalize, okay, I need to go for this internship or I need to go for that internship? So what would be your take on this?
You know, one thing you should not forget, that one thing I mentioned during my responses, that I was attending the conferences, right?
Yes.
Still also. So when I was attending the conferences, I was meeting with the industry people as well.
Okay. Yes.
Because they are coming for their, you know, some showcasing their product services. So because of own interest and all, and, you know, communication, formal communication, empathetic communication between the two parties. So whenever I was sharing my card with them and sharing, so they also, you know, very much, you know, conversant with me. Then for, so because of my industry connection, because of my academic connection, university found out that I'm the suitable person, right?
Okay.
And as a academician, as a faculty, it is also my responsibility to help my students, right? Isn't it? So these two things again matches, and I was appointed in my department as a faculty coordinator for these kind of activities. So it is a simple one. I don't know whether how the people, because everybody has their own strategy to communicate. So I send the formal emails to my colleagues, because they are also the colleague. They know me, I know them, right? And I will ask them, okay, what kind of projects they are, you know, offering in the coming semester, summer semester particularly, because, and so they send their requirement to me. Then I will match and make the dialogue with the student and the companies. So, and one thing visualized during my this conversation, I'm more eager to learn actually, right? So, and this assignment I have opted because I want to update myself. What industry actually need? How, so as a professor, if I am aware directly what industry is looking for, as a faculty, I can align my lectures, I can align my discussion with that expectation, and I can train my students, right?
Yeah.
So what is happening in this sequence? I'm the medium, industry is one point, the student is one point, I'm the medium. So information is flowing through some faculty like me. That thing helped me. And I as a student, I want, as a faculty, I want to save the time of the student, because if you are doing blah, blah things, nothing will be worked out. When I go to the classroom, I always, share my knowledge that, okay, this is happening, you know, this is expected. So guys, you please align yourself. I am available. Your professor colleagues are available. If you are looking for some other professor, you come to me. I will make the connection between you. So that thing also practicize. I practice this in my university, and I have improved a lot. I'm updated still also. I'm getting thousands of emails, you know, Sometimes I have no time to read actually. So it is now converted into one of the biggest database actually. So I'm getting all international universities, fellowships, research. So it was not easy for me actually in this 15 to 20 years journey. But yes, I'm still learning. And so this faculty coordinatorship related to the internship and placements, it is not a that much difficult job. And I'm not paid. One thing I would like to add before going to the next one. Here I'm not paid extra by the university. It is a free service which I'm doing for the students.
Okay, that's good. That's good. Yeah. So as a part of your teaching life, you have also been a resource person at various FDPs. So the way that FDPs happen has changed a lot in the past 1 year. Means how they used to happen before this lockdown and online stuff, and the way they happen now. So what is the one major change that you have observed in that style and this style? And what is the one thing that you liked in that style or in this style? So this is, what is that?
Yeah, I understood your question. Thank you, Chandan. You know, for me, there is no change.
Okay.
Because I could not mention so far because I was the, I do not know, I'm not claiming that I'm the first one. But I was the pioneer one who believes in knowledge sharing. So I started this online FDP training since 2012.
Okay.
So because I believe that when I was going and invited by some institute or university, I found that some of the people are coming from far places, you know. Some are stuck up in the train, some are stuck up in somewhere. Somebody has not, you know, having the money to pay that particular event fee to attend these sessions. Whether it's a session of mine, whether it's a session of some other expert. Okay. So that thing, you know, inspired me came that I should go to their desk. I should go to their terminal. Then I started the online faculty development program. So for many people, I'm not claiming because there is no instrument to judge that whether I was the first one, I was the second one, I was the 10th one. But I believe that at that point in time during 2012 or 2013, there was no faculty organizing online faculty development or scholar development program. I took the initiative and I start classes conducting on Skype and some, you know, there were other platforms also, but I have majorly used Skype. So I made the groups of 2-3 students were coming, scholar. They said, sir, we request you, could you conduct this? I said, okay, we'll share the knowledge, no problem. So for me, related to your question, it is not a new experience for me. Because I'm already doing since more than 8 years now.
That's great.
It's online. And as far as the conventional classroom faculty delivery and online faculty delivery is concerned, yes, both the things are different. In online classes, for me, you know, there is always a connect with the audience. That I can feel it, even my audience can also feel it, which I'm getting the, you know, they are responsive through, because many students, they are going in this FTP, that FTP, still they are not getting the solution.
Yes, this happens.
They have no clarity. And if you attend more, then again confusion would come. That is my proven claiming response. That definitely the confusion.
Yes, it happens. So coming back to again your journey, how you started. So I would like to know about the very first research paper that you wrote. How did that came and how did that executed and how it actually was done? Your very first research paper.
Yeah, so it is a great question. Thank you, Chandan. I still remember that I have written one research paper for some of the national conference. It was in Pusat. Pusat is a place in Maharashtra. In the district of Yavatmal. So when I was doing and started some bit of research, because as I told you, my professor, you do this. I was looking their brochure, you know, I was novice actually. Even now also I have believed that I am novice. मैं कुछ नहीं जानता हूँ. So that thing is there, and I have never say that when I was a student, when I am now faculty or a trainer, whatever you can call. I never, you know, feeling never allowed such kind of feeling that I know everything. So when I started my research paper, this kind of, you know, the feelings were also there.
Okay.
So what I've decided, there was a call came from some southern, Yavatmal, this Baba Sahib Nai College of Engineering. And they were invited, you know, papers from the students, professionals, practitioners. So I have written, you know, one paper on some Bluetooth technology or something, because I was doing in more electronics when I was in BSc. So I've started paper writing in BSc. So you understand, BSc students only have no time to attend the class and all. So no time for the doing the extra research. So whatever the idea came, I'm not claiming that was a very good research paper. But whatever I have understood, whatever the way, you know, so I'm talking about, you know, long back, you know, 1999, 2000.
Okay.
So then I wrote some paper, and it was a basic paper, not a research paper. You can say it was a review paper, I should say. I've submitted, and finally call came. Then I went there. Then I presented my research work and everything, whatever I have done. So it was not very much great. Even now also, whenever I do my research and submitting to journals and conferences. So I believe that, okay, if selected, accepted, it's okay, I will do this. If not accepted, I will again improve the paper.
So as a last question for this podcast, I would like to ask you that, what message will you like to give to your younger self? Like, if you meet your younger self who is like 10 to 20 years back, so what message will you like to give to yourself, your younger self?
So, Miss, your question is particularly related to the research community, or it is
life-wise? Life-wise or all over?
All over, as I think I've already answered this question before too, that they should understand their expectation first. That is the message. They should spend good time with them, right? And they should not be in hurry. They should be patientful to understand their pros and cons, their challenges. Challenge is not like that they can with a, you know, quick kind of thing, they can solve this thing. Okay. There is no magic actually in the life. Anybody's life, your life, my life, there is no magic. But there is a strategy, there is a plan. Okay. So the message to the community, to my colleagues, my youngers, my students, professionals, that they should go with the time management first. Second, they should revisit their own challenges and opportunities. And they should understand other advices also given by the experts. Because that thing also helps, because they have already experienced it, and the younger one, they will experience it. So little bit changes is okay. We should not completely rely on the professional. We should not completely rely on ourselves. Okay, this is my plan. Okay, I should do it. Who has testified? Nobody has testified. We are going to testify. So the message to the community is, they should be very much clear about their pros and cons, challenges, opportunities. They should be ethical one to themselves. They should understand, listen their peers, senior, junior, whosoever they believe, but not many.
I got
there
it.
Is a pause. Not many. All gurus are not all gurus, you know. So this is simple, you know, message to the community.
So I thank you so much for giving me time to come for this podcast and share your life experiences with us, and I hope that our viewers will get something from it. They will benefit from it. So with this, I would like to wrap up the podcast. And once again, thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Chintan. It is a great talking to you, and thank you giving me an opportunity to share my life experiences with you, with the community of YouTube channel or many community professionals. Thank you very much.